Hi, welcome back to vMake DevOps. Today we are having agenda to take Kubernetes backup, restore, migration, use cases for Velero project. We will see the introduction of Velero, what is the Velero, and at last we will do a demo in which we will see how we can restore a Kubernetes namespace. Let's start, and this screenshot I took from Velero site itself, as it's shown that Velero is an open source tool that helps to backup, restore, and perform disaster recovery, as well as migrate our Kubernetes resource with persistent volume on another cluster. So first we will talk about Kubernetes itself. In Kubernetes, there is a two type of data. One is we are categorized as stateless, that we can say master node and the old worker node. Another one is the stateful. There we are having a distributed database that we are calling as etcd, and after that we are having persistent volume. If I'm talking about the stateless, then taking backup of master node and worker node is quite easy, because we are having the lot of automation nowadays. Like we are having Ansible, we are having say Puppet, we can schedule, we can put the alert for unhealthy node, we can drain them, cordon them, and whatever process to maintain them healthy we can do with the help of automation. Now I'm coming on the stateful. Here we are having tactical solution, like we are having some solution for etcd database, we are having solution for persistent volume, but still these are much not evolved. Like here I categorize here, that is the strategically way by which we can do that stateful data restoration. Like we can put etcd as a itself distributed database, we can create something block storage for them, we can save it on the file system. We are having command line etcdtl, we can put whole namespace, a whole etcd backup itself, or at last we are having Kubernetes API discovery method by which we can take the backup for etcd. Same way in case of persistent volume also, we are having some cloud storage provider, they're providing the snapshot, we can take backup on the file system, or at last that CSI snapshot. Let's start Velero feature, but before doing the feature we need to know how Velero is work. It is based on CRD. So for each Velero operation, a CRD is created and it stored in etcd, as well as it will create controller object for Kubernetes. So if we are having controller object inside the Kubernetes, we will not need to talk directly to etcd before to taking backup, as well as Velero going to support many cloud provider that we will see in the next slide. With the help of these provider, we will put our backup directly on the cloud object storage. I hope Velero is all support. Velero is supporting almost all provider, and if it not going to support some cloud provider, like if something you are having new, then we are having some plugin that you can customize your cloud provider. After that, it's having some kind of flexibility, like you can schedule your backup, so your incremental backup is running fine. And after that, you are having option, you can take the backup for namespace, you can take the backup for resource, you can use the label selector. After that, it having some automation, like you can set up your hooks. The plugin is very important part for Velero, because already we discussed that Velero is going to store their data into the cloud storage object. For that, we are having these many plugin, like it is a plugin for AWS, plugin for GCP. So we can use these plugin, and based on these plugin, we can choose the provider. Now, this slide also I took from their Velero site. It's saying that I'm not going to deep dive for these slides, but I'm just reading that highlighted one, like it helped to disaster recovery, your data migration, and the AP thermal cluster. Now we will see Velero workflow. So first we will see in this slide how Velero going to take Kubernetes resource backup. So first of all, it will start with Velero client, because already we discussed that Velero is working the Velero client and server mode. So first of all, Velero client going to create a call to Kubernetes API server to create a backup object. Like here you can see that Velero, we executed a command with the help of here we put here hyphen hyphen include namespace. It means we are going to call for a particular namespace. So once that call is done to Kubernetes API server, then we are having backup controller, Velero backup controller inside the Kubernetes server. So this Velero backup controller start authenticate and validate backup. Once this validation is done, then backup controller begin the backup process. After that, at the last point, backup controller make a call to object storage provider to upload the backup, and our backup get restored, our backup gets stored on storage provider. The same way, in case of restore, again the Velero client requesting for a restore call, and the same way Velero restore controller here, first of all, during the backup we saw that Velero backup controller going to call, but in case of restore we are having Velero restore controller, it do the call on the storage provider, and after authenticate that storage provider, it is going to restore the same backup on the Kubernetes server with the help of Kubernetes API server. So that is the whole process. Now we will start our demo. So in case of our demo, we require a Velero server and Velero client as well as a storage provider. So in this case, we are going to take a S3 storage bucket based on the Minio server, because we don't have a AWS bucket here. So first of all, we have to download Velero client. So I downloaded it from this GitHub release. There is a number of way that you can use Helm chart as well, but in my case, I'm easy to take as on the release page itself. So I install it. I took for Mac, so I took this version. And after that, when I install it, automatically I will get one directory there, example. And based on the example, I'm having that Minio deployment file. And in this Minio deployment file, I change node port 30,000. So easy, I can see on the my local system. And I deployed Minio, that is easy to deploy. So now Minio server is running on my local system. And after that, with the help of Velero, after that I created the credential file for Minio. When I deploy the Minio, that in deployment file, we have two option to provide credential. So I put this Minio and Minio 123 as a credential, and the same I put in the credential file itself. So because of this credential file, when we are going to call our Velero server from the Velero client, then it's easy to recognize for Velero client what is credential for our server. So here I authenticate Velero client with this object storage that you can see here, my Minio server, and to our Kubernetes API server. So while doing that, it will install Velero server inside the Kubernetes cluster. Once Velero server get installed in our Kubernetes server, then Velero backup controller is already get set up. Velero backup controller and restore controller both get set up. So now we have to verify like how the restoration and backup process will work. So for that, because already we are having a storage provider as S3 Minio, we are having already installed Velero server with the Velero client, and now we will create a pod here as well as a PVC. Because what I'm going to achieve here, first of all, I'm going to create here a namespace that I created already, that Nginx. In that namespace, I'm going to deploy a PVC of 5 MB, and after that I'm going to deploy a pod. So once I deploy the pod and PVC, I will get on here kubectl get pod hyphen n Nginx. So I'm having here one pod is running, that having one PVC. So I'm going to here to show you PVC as well. So PVC is already bounded, and my Velero server is running here. Here my Velero server is running. So based on that, my Velero server, I created my S3 storage as well. Now I'm going to create a storage object for backup. So here, if I'm going to here, I'm having these already some storage, demo storage now, already some backup is already there, but we will create a new one. So this is the command by which we can create the Velero. We can send the command to here. I'm going to create the name. I'm going to here Nginx 1. So it is started to create a storage backup for this Nginx, and that I took as a whole namespace for Nginx. So whatever things are into my Nginx namespace, it's get here stored on this Minio S3 server. So now you can see here that my backup get stored here. Now I'm going to do here kubectl delete namespace Nginx. So by doing this one, I will get read out of my running Nginx port as well as my PVC. It will take some time, and once it done, we will check again that it's get deleted or not. And after that, we are going to restore the same backup from that S3 bucket. Yes, it's done. Now kubectl get pod hyphen n Nginx. Nothing will be there. Now I'm going to restore the same backup that we just created. And here I took the name as Nginx 1. So this backup is restored instantly because it's only 5 MB PVC attached to it. So kubectl get pod hyphen n Nginx hyphen w. And see, the port gets started again. And if I go here on the Minio, if I go here, restore object, I can see here that my Nginx get restored. We can see here like it doing that incremental as well. So we can put into with some schedule or hooks as well. So this is all demo to how to take a backup for a namespace with the help of Velero.